why do I continue to open the mind and the doors of this university to Sarah and to any activity that she has in mind, to any student whom she is eager to educate? The answer is very simple. Because her vision and mission is the university's vision and mission. We are committed to not spending a lot of time talking. We do apply research, but we don't spend a lot of time researching for the sake of researching. Rather, we have one strong commitment, and that is to build and sustain assets in the Northwest Corridor. We made a pledge that we would give voice to the people of the Northwest Corridor, so that all would be strong partners in the city of Charlotte. We have not been afraid to speak out and to challenge those who we feel have no interest in us as a people. We have challenged those who've said that we are at the end of nowhere. We continue to challenge those who think that we simply want to tinker with toys. We challenge those who look at our communities and say that we do not need diversity of educational experiences for our students. That's the institutional commitment. Sarah Stevenson is the personal commitment, the conscience, in my opinion, of this city. Demand, frustrate, upset anyone who believes that the Northwest Corridor does not deserve sustainable assets. She will challenge those who are intellectually dishonest, who will speak eloquently, but will do very little when it comes time to demonstrate their commitment to the Northwest Corridor. When students need help, she will go into my pocket and your pockets as I mentioned, to make sure that these students are educated. And why? Because just as Johnson C. Smith University is committed to the growing edge of this community, Sarah Stevenson is committed to the growing edge of everyone who walks in this community. She represents the epitome of leadership. And here is the definition. When your mind is fastened to an omniscient vision, and all your thoughts and all your desires are pointed to it, it is there. It is right there in that moment. God gives you the power to do that one thing. And that's why we are here today, to celebrate this woman who has indeed kept an omniscient vision, rooted deeply in her veins, unwavering, waiting for that centering moment when God would say to her, this one thing you will do. And with that affirmation, she says, here I rise. We honor you, our mother, our mentor, our leader. And we welcome all of you who have the courage to cross the artificial boundaries, as Bishop Bella does it so well, to cross all the artificial boundaries, to simply say we can gather around her as we, the people. God bless you all, and thank you for being here.